a very tender fish fillet and its golden crispy skin with a rich and creamy red curry sauce. This is Shu Shi Pla, a delicious and easy Thai fish curry with coconut milk. Khafelam leaves are an absolute must for this dish because of its fresh fragrance. I'm going to grab the base of the stem and pull it off. Then I'm going to thinly slice it. To do so, I like to roll the leaves together. And because this is the pretty tough leaf, so you have to slice it as thin as you can. Then we can put it aside. We will use it in the end to garnish the dish. But for the ones I will put in the sauce, chop it really finely. It's hard to chew, so it's best to avoid having too big pieces in the sauce. Because you can remove the garnish if you don't want to eat it, but we still need khafelam leaf for the taste, and it's more difficult to remove them from the sauce, right? The next one is my red chili. I don't need more spicy because my red curry paste is spicy enough. By the way, I'm not showing you how to make a red curry paste today because I already made a video about it. Go check it if you want to make a nice homemade paste. So back to chili. Any my chili is great. I'm going to cut it to remove the seeds. Then very thinly slice it. And we will also use it as a garnish in the end. Now turn the gas over medium heat, bring a wok or a pan, and we are ready to make the yummy red curry sauce. At the beginning, I'm going to add some coconut milk into the wok. We are going to fry the coconut milk and the red curry paste together to allow its aroma come out. After the coconut milk comes to boil, I'm going to add my homemade red curry paste. You don't have to make it yourself, but it's definitely better. We will give it a stir and let the sauce reduce until it's thick and the coconut oil starts separating from the paste. It should take about 3 to 4 minutes. As you can see, there's a lot of oil that's bubbling around the edges of the curry paste. That's when you know it's ready for the next step. Note that if you use store-bought curry paste, you should taste it before the next step because sometimes it's salty already. But if you feel it's not, it's time to season the paste with some palm sugar, fish sauce, and salt. Stir to combine the paste very well. And before the next step, please take a second to give this video a thumbs up if you like it so far. Then I'm going to add the chopped khafelam leaves. This herb really brings aromatics and citrusy smell into the sauce. Now I will add the rest of the coconut milk. Stir to mix for half a minute. I'm going to turn off the gas and set this aside. Then I'm going to work on the fish. I've got fish fillet pieces here and I kept the skin on because I want a crispy skin texture in my dish. FYI, make sure the fish skin is dry because when it comes in the hot pan, the moisture can make the oil splatter. Once again, I'm not going to show you how to prepare a fish fillet today. I explained it in this video already. Now, if your fish is ready, let's get started. In a bowl, I'm mixing some corn flour and baking soda together. This flour mixture will make the fish skin really nice and crispy. Now bring the fish skin side down to the mixture, then pat off the excess flour and place the fish into the hot oil. Repeat this step with the rest of your fish fillets. Now sprinkle the fish meat with some black pepper and salt to season it. We will fry the skin for about 2 to 3 minutes until it gets really nice and crispy. Then flip to cook the bottom side for a few minutes as well. I think my fish skin is not fried enough, so I will leave it 1 to 2 more minutes. Now, that's what I'm talking about. Super tender meat and beautiful golden crispy skin. It's not finished yet. Let's set the fish aside just for a minute and start to reheat the red curry sauce on medium heat. Then place the fish fillets into the sauce. and let it stay for a few minutes to allow the flavor from the curry paste go inside the fish meat. To have the best texture and flavor, you have to serve it right away with some hot steamed rice.
If fish is your thing, have you ever tried Thai crispy fish with chili sauce? If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to shove that like button and subscribe for more delicious Thai recipe. Thank you for watching. See you next week. ขอบคุณค่ะ. Bye bye.